There's a new law that came out last year, Jack Straw brought it out. You know, this was prophesied 2,000 years ago, man. You know, what's happening here? You know. It's going to be stamped next year in the House of Commons. Lock them up and throw the key away, you know. I saw that on teletext. Phew, this is a bit heavy, isn't it? Phew. That quick, you know. Putin, the Russian leader, don't trust him. He made a deal with the mad dictator, the devil, and he's here. I mean, this is what he said, I'll come like a thief in the night, but I'll give you signs. You know, you just got to accept this is going to happen and let it happen, like, you know. Like as I said, you know, through the Jack Straw thing.
We had a man that used to come in with a snake. He knew I hated snakes. He used to take it to work with him in a hold all night. And he said, I brought Barney in to show you. And it was a huge, big python. Oh, and I cringed. The only way I would ever purchase a snake would be on a pair of shoes or a handbag. And I shouldn't say that, really. I mean, I don't wear fur. I mean, I have got a fun fur coat and a fun fur hat, but I do like leather shoes and leather handbags, so I don't particularly go in for animal-free cosmetics, but if I found an animal-free cosmetic that I would suit my skin, then I would probably buy it. But, I mean, I just go to Boots the Chemist and buy a foundation and eyeliner, and that's about my lot.
I was quite surprised to see all the flags still up, and I said to them, why are you still flying the flags? It's the Jubilee, my dear, he said. And that was on the top of the highest mountain in Menorca, so we were very impressed by that. We had a street party, of course. We're lucky enough to have a village green. We put up marquees, and the children ran races, and they dressed up. They dressed as queens and things like that. Oh yes, it was weird. We all felt quite stunned. We also celebrated when Diane and Prince Charles got engaged, but not to the extent that I was legless. The sun shone and we had a beautiful afternoon, which went on into the night.
Not being critical of Giorgio Mental, I read a book over in Waterstone Bookshop. What I read in there, it really blew my mind. In his last book, he written now, the Pope John Paul, the woman who won as the Pope now, he reckons feed your body with tablets and just stay in constant confusion. They say, well, how would you see the world? You must be on some bloody magic mushroom trip or something. Time is so fast. The pace of time is so fast. We're nearly halfway through a year. So fast gone. Tonight, now there's nothing much on the telly. Going to the training, going to the kickboxing, like, you know. Done it all, drugs, drink, you know, crime, done it all. I only wish I knew now, at 43, what I knew when I was 19. Everything in life's going to be balanced. If it's not, then it becomes chemically unbalanced.
Dogs are my favourite animals. I've always been brought up with dogs. We had a cat when we was kids, like, purely for the mousing, because we used to live on a bit of a small holding. I don't mind mice. My children have had mice and guinea pigs and birds. We had a budgie for 14 years, old Charlie, that used to swear at you. My oldest brothers used to teach him to swear. I didn't. We don't keep fish as wet fish, but we keep a few of the accessories, such as the foods, tanks, collars and leads, harnesses, flea shampoos, tin meats, every type of chew, every type of biscuit that's available to these little creatures. mouse poison, though, which we shouldn't say that, really, because we're animal lovers.
This is a little bit dicey. I admire the Queen. I'm a bit concerned about her family, and I am a bit concerned about the hangers-on in the royal family. They seem to be getting bigger and bigger. Princess Michael of Kent. Princess Michael of Kent. Princess Michael of Kent. We call her Princess Pushy because she's got that nickname. We happened to be in Spain when Diana was killed. And it was the most beautiful thing I think I've ever seen. They set aside a room for us. British people were allowed to go into this room and we watched the funeral. But they had a special room for the Germans too, and they were equally moved. Yes, I feel sorry for the princes. I admire them. I think Harry's gone a little bit off, in my opinion.